Now, in this video, we are going to take up one more problem on the second quadrant. A point is 30 mm behind VP, 30 mm above HP, and 20 mm in front or behind or from RPP. Draw its projections and name the side view. So, in the previous case, it was 25 mm in front or behind or from LPP. Now, it's in this case, we are taking to the right profile plane. So, as we look from the, since the condition given is behind VP and above HP, so obviously the point has to be in the second quadrant, behind VP and above HP. So, obviously the point should be in the second quadrant, and 20 mm in front or behind or from RPP, since it is behind VP, obviously it should be behind RPP. So, behind RPP means we have to look from the right side view. When you look from the right side view, the point will be, this is the right profile plane you have. So, behind that, so it will be this distance. So, when you look from the front view, we can see the distance above HP. And when you look from the front view, it is projected onto the vertical plane. So, you're going to get this point here. So, this distance is above HP. And also, when you look from the front view, we can see the distance behind RPP. So, this projected here to get the vertical plane here, on this vertical plane. So, this 20 mm. So, similarly, when you look from the top view, we can see the distance behind VP. So, this distance behind VP, and when it is projected from the, when it is projected onto horizontal plane, the image will going to falls on the horizontal plane. So, this point, so this distance will be behind VP. And also, when you look from the top view, we can see the distance behind RPP. So, that distance of 20 mm is seen here. Similarly, when you look from the right side view, we can see the distance above HP, and when it is projected, you are going to see the distance here, and also behind VP, this is the distance behind VP which can be seen in the right side view. So, that distance when it is projected, you will be able to see this here. So, when you cut it and rotate it, so then VP and HP will overlap and RPP will going to come to the right side. So, obviously, we are going to have the distances here. This is the behind VP distance, behind RPP distance can be seen in both VP and HP. And when you look from the above HP is 30 mm here, and also behind VP is 30 mm. So, obviously, both P dash and P top view will be overlapping, as the HP is the one which has been rotated. So, P image is written in bracket. And also, when you look from the right side view, we can see the distance above HP and also the behind VP. When RPP is rotated, above HP is still vertical. So, you are drawn a line to the profile view. So, you are going to get this distance is above HP. And then behind VP, when it is projected to the plane, so you are going to get behind VP here, behind RPP here, which is 20 mm behind RPP distance. Then that is behind VP distance, which is also 30. And when it is, it has to become horizontal when it is rotated in the when the right side view it becomes horizontal. So draw a 45 degree line here so that this vertical distance of 30 mm is transferred into horizontal distance. And where you have the front view, on that line only you will going to get the side view. So you project this still to the where you have the projected line from the front view. So the intersection of these two lines will going to give you P double dash, so which is the right side view. Now we will going to write the final solution. First, we are going to draw the XY line and X1, Y1 line, and then mark XY and X1, Y1, identify the planes of VP, HP and RPP, then project, draw for 20 mm behind RPP can be seen in both VP and HP. So, you draw a parallel line to X1, Y1 line at a distance of 20 mm, and then from XY line you measure 30 and you mark this point as P dash and bracket P, because HP is the one which is rotated and both will go to overlap. So, draw a 45 degree line adjacent to HP and project the top view point onto 45 degree line. Then behind VP, which is 30 in the vertical, is become horizontal, and where, and also draw a horizontal line. Also, you draw a horizontal projector from P dash, both P dash and P double dash, we have both P dash and P, both top view and the front view will going to be on this, and P double dash and P will going to be on the same line. So, this distance with respect to the XY will be above HP, which is 30 mm, and then behind VP, 30 mm will be from here to here. So, the point what you will going to get is P double dash, and this will going to be the right side view. Now, This is how we will be able to get the solution. And now we will going to same thing, we are going to write it in the AutoCAD software. To do that, first we will go to the AutoCAD screen, switch off the grid mode and switch on the ortho mode. Now we will first, we are going to type the command limits. Take the specify lower left corner 0, 0, upper right corner you take 297, 210, then zoom all. Now we go for the line command, select some arbitrary point at the lower, at some distance, and by clicking on the first button of the mouse and drag the mouse to the right direction, take some distance and click on first button of the mouse and drag the mouse to the top side, take some distance and click on first button of the mouse, then go to offset, take the distance as 297, select the vertical line and offset to the left side, then again by default exit. So go to the previous command is offset, take the offset distance and type the distance as 210, select this horizontal line and offset to the top side, then go to zoom, extends and zoom 0.6x, then go to fillet, select this vertical line and this horizontal line, similarly horizontal line and this vertical line, and select this vertical line and this horizontal line, then go to zoom window, select this and go to detext, specify start point, take some point and take the height as 4 and rotation angle as 0 and type the problem number 10. So here a point is 30 mm behind VP, then 30 mm above HP and above HP and 20 mm behind or in front or from RPP, name the side view, name, draw the projections and name the side view. And now you just come out of this. So now we will go to and first we'll draw the XY and X1, Y1 line and then write VP, HP and RPP. And first we're going to do that. So to do that, first we will go for zoom window. Take near to the screen, go to line, switch on the ortho mode, select some arbitrary point on the screen by taking the line command, take some distance and click on the first button of the mouse to get the horizontal line. Again, go to line command, specify first point, select some point and draw a vertical line to some distance and click on the first button of the mouse. Then go to detext. So here you take the text height, previous text height set first 4. Now you're going to set it as 3 and say OK and put the caps lock on and type the vertical plane. First identify the planes first, then go to HP, then you type RPP here. Then we'll go to layer, click on new, type the layer by name XY, type the layer by name front view, type the layer by name top view, and again click on layer, type the layer by name side view. Then change the line weights. Line weight of layer 0, which is 0.05, because all the projector lines should be of 0.05. Then the layer XY should be of 0.13. You select this and say OK. And then the front view will going to have the magenta color. Then OK. Then the top view should have red. Just take red. And side view should have blue. So take blue and say OK. And finally, you close this. Then go to zoom window. You select this. Then first, we're going to draw a line parallel to X1, Y1 line at a distance of 20 and draw a 30 mm parallel line with respect to the XY line in the top side, and then mark these points. So to do that, so first we're going to come down to offset, take the distance as 20, select this vertical line and offset to the left side, then go to offset, take the distance as 30, go select this line and offset. Then go to line, take INT of this and take at the rate 100 less than 45, then go to trim, select this and trim this line till here. Then go to trim, select these two and also this line, and trim this line here, and trim this line here, and trim this line here. Then go to donut, so select the point as 0 and take the diameter as 3, outside diameter, take intersection point of this and take int of this. Then go to break, break this line till here, then break this line till here, then break this line till here, and then break this line till here. Then go to break, select this line till here, and then erase this line. Now we'll go for dText. Type this as x, and type this as y, and type this as x1, and type this as y1, and put the caps lock off, type p dash, and also in bracket p, and here type this as p double dash. Now we will going to move accordingly, place it, switch off the ortho mode, take it and place it appropriately. So then come down to RPP. So here we have a p double dash, then you take p dash, and then you take p. So here x, you take this as y, and take this as x1 and y1. So once you do that, so now we take VP nearer. So now we will going to change the layers. So to do that, so here first you're going to click on these two and also this. So go to CH, so go to layer, make this as the side view. Then you click on this VP, this and do this, go to CH, name that layer as front view. Then again you click on this and you click on this, go to CH, go to layer, make this as top view. Then here go to DDIM, change the settings of the dimensioning variables. So lines should have offset from the origin as 2. Then symbols and arrows, take the arrow size as 3. Then go to text, take the text head as default as arrow size, take 3, align with the dimension line. Text placement vertical becomes above, and also offset from the dimension line as 2. Then go to primary units, make this linear dimension precision should be 0, and say OK, and then close. Now we're going to do the dimensioning. So dim, then go to center of, because center, because donut is there, take this and take intersection point of this and take this distance as 20. Then go to vertical, you take center of this and take int of this and take this distance as 30. Then go to angular, select this line and you select this line and take this angle as 45. Then come out of this, then go to leader, take center of this and put the ortho off, click on this and you select this ortho on and escape, sorry, leader, take center of this, put the ortho off, and now you ortho on, go to annotation, options, and none. So go to dText, put the ortho on, caps lock on, type RSV, and then go to select CH and type the layer by name side view. So you're going to get this. Now here I need to give the leader, go to nearest point on this. Now you drag this and go to annotation, option, and none, then go to explode X, select this line and explode it, so that you are going to erase this line, so that the arrowhead will going to be retained. Otherwise what happens is it will going to erase both the arrowhead and the line. So to keep the only the arrowhead, we have to take the leader, because it is a block consisting of the leader, arrowhead, and also the line. So once you explore that, both these two will going to become separate, and then you erase the line. So this is how this procedure will going to be done. So now we're going to compare this with this drawing. So since we have completed all the things which has been entered here, so now this will going to give the final solution, since CSK is the name the side view, we have named the side view also. Thank you.